The sky is still pink, but we are not at ease. Birds are still chirping, but we have lost the peace. Nights are getting darker, and the days are all quiet. Moon is still shiny, but dwindling is the hope. Just praying for the day when fear will be gone. Looking at each other, smile will be on. The sun will be bright and shiny, blessing us all. Kids will get to play and the mask will be gone.
London Bridge is falling down.
Hello everyone, this is Jyoti. Welcome to Tranquil Living Jazz. I hope you all are safe and sound. So we all are going through tough times. For most of us, family, friends are far apart, and the only option left with us is to stay connected virtually. So I wish and hope future holds better for us. We all come out of this healthy and obviously alive. So we are going to change our approach. Since we cannot go out, we are going to make some videos which are possible within our house. So you'll get to see a lot of furniture flips, a few makeovers, a few DIY videos. And please be mindful, the resources are very limited. I'll try to make use of whatever I have at my home or whatever is available at doorstep delivery. So yes, you're going to see a lot of DIY videos. I wish and hope you like it. So it's Corona and we cannot go out. So what to do? We can only renovate our house. So this is what I'm going to work on this time. So this is an old piece of furniture. It was a big almira. We got it cut, used it as a bookshelf. Then it has been used to dump toys. So now it's time to make something good out of it. So I'm planning to give it a good coat of paint, varnish, a good shade of green, I believe, and a few beautiful touches, and it will be a classy piece of furniture. My heart is on the line. Stay by my side, just tonight. In the morning, we can pick up the fight. Don't give up on me. Abhi, can you please introduce yourself to everyone?
Abhyuday Mata. I'm 10 years old. I live in Delhi. I have a YouTube channel. It's called Awaken the Genius Within You. And that's about it.
So Abhi will be with us for the entire duration, as long as he wants to be here, because he is getting bored and he wants to be a part of the process. So this is the cabinet which we are going to paint. I have taken off the shelves. Those are detachable ones, so I have taken them off so that I can paint the inside also. So the process goes the same. We'll sand the surface, then we'll clean it up, and then we'll apply a coat of paint. So whatever material we need, I have all kept it here. So let me just walk you through. First, an important thing, rolling brush. So I've taken a 6-inch brush now so that my work gets done easily and faster. If you take a smaller one, it takes a long time to complete the entire area. Then paint. So again, I've taken a shade 7807 from Asian Paints Royale. Then I have these. So these are going to be the legs for the cabinet. So since it's a long cabinet, I have taken 5 legs so that I can give a support in the center as well. So these are going to be the legs. And yes, to attach it to this cabinet, since it's a particle board cabinet, the screws I cannot use because they won't do well in the particle board. So what I'll do, I'll use araldite. I'll put some araldite and then use nail as well to stick it to the base. So that's about it. Sandpaper to sand the surface, cloth to clean the surface, hammer, araldite, and yes, some nails. So that's all that we need. And yes, one more thing, this So these are the pine wood boards. I have got it cut in the measurement as per my, you know, the cabinet. So I will give it a good coat of stain because my TV unit entire wall has stained wooden planks. So I will give it a matching stain which will go in front so that this cabinet ties up with the entire wall of my TV unit. So this will go at the end. So yeah, it's done. It's time to just get the work done. If you can see this, so this is a particle board, so if we try to put in a screw it will not hold it at all. So that's the reason I'm not going for the screws, instead I'll go for the nails. And since it was a part of a bigger almirah earlier, so you could see there are the holes because we separated it off the bigger almirah. So we'll just sand it and then we'll try to fill them up with putty just to make the surface more smooth. So for now I'm just sanding the places wherever I need to attach the legs so that I can put it all right, because this coating is all paper, so I don't want to attach it over paper. I'll just get the paper off, then I'll put it all right and attach the legs. So this one we were not able to keep it at the same place for a long time, so this is what we have done. We have put it one side. Now I'll paste everything because this takes only 5-10 minutes for the wood to stick. So we'll let them rest at this position. Once they are a bit connected to the wood, then we'll just turn it out and just put in two nails on each leg so that it holds them for a longer run. So yeah, I'm going to paste all 5 of them now. Top so that it sticks well. So last one, all 4 are done. Pots are doing the job. What a beautiful sight it is, see. Prior to becoming a TV cabinet, it was gonna stand for the pots.
Bye-bye.
So we are done with sticking them, as you can see. So it will take some time to dry. I'm thinking to take a quick break and then come back and again start the process of cleaning the other parts and sanding it as well. This side sanding I have done, because anyhow it will come in the bottom, so no need to spend that much energy and time in the bottom part. We'll have to work it in a better way on the top side because that will be visible from the front. So yeah, let's take a break.
I took a sandpaper and did the sanding on the edges of the planks. And I had ordered 2 stains, one oak wood and one brown, but turns out the brown was red in color, which was delivered. So yes, I took some wood oil, mixed the stain, more of oak wood yellow, and red I used in the corners to give a little shade of red, followed by a coat of varnish to safeguard the wood.
So time to put the putty, because if you can see there are some gaps because it was almirah, it was the place for the lock. Also there are little spaces there also, these ones which I need to fill. Project done by today itself, and I'll have weekend for myself to rest, but that doesn't seem like the case because weather is not cooperating. It's about to rain and it looks like it's going to rain entire night, so instead of here we had to shift it inside the house because we can't risk it because too much of water will come here, and I haven't painted the legs yet with varnish, so yeah, it's risky, so we moved it inside. But yeah, tomorrow we have to work around a few options because the color which we painted, we have run out of that. We don't have it anymore and we cannot go out also. So I have few shades of color left with me. I don't know how many, but there are a few shades. So I'll look at them tomorrow and I'll see if I can make it work with all the different colors. So yeah, you'll get to see a DIY with limited options which we have available at home. But yeah, I'll try my level best that it looks good. So yeah, tomorrow it is to see what it comes to be. For now, you can enjoy the weather. Hello everyone, so this is day 2. Today we will try and wrap up with the cabinet. So I looked for the colors which I had. Seems I have this and one yellow also with me. I have some teal as well which I'm not willing to use. So let's see if I can make use some of these of colors and finish it up. So I'm reusing these supports which we took it out of the almira again, just to lift it up a little bit more, and so that if there is any water on the floor, wood will not be impacted.
I'm taking some varnish and mixing in the oak wood stain for the legs. Where you hide? Late night drinking, wishful thinking. What if you were here? Morning waking, heart still aching. Something about the way you make me feel. I don't wanna mess up your night. I don't wanna put.
Feel. I don't wanna mess up your night. I don't.
The green color which I had was able to, you know, cover up this entire area, shells also. So now I'm left with the varnish where I had mixed the oak wood stain. So I'm going to give the inner side a coat of varnish itself, because I just want to keep it a bit rusty in the center, because I'll be filling it up with books. So yeah, I'm making use of the varnish now. So we are done with paint. Now the final thing left is a quick coat of varnish on the top so that it gives a good shine. So all done with the varnish. Now I'm going to attach these. I had already painted them yesterday and had given a varnish coat also. So these will go on both the corners. One will come on the top and the other one will go here under that. The varnish is a bit wet, so I'm not attaching this one as of now, but this one I'll attach. So both the sides will have two each. It should look good. How you been? Where you hide? Late night drinking, wishful thinking, what if you were here? Morning waking, heart still aching, something about the way you make me feel. I don't wanna mess up your night, I don't wanna put up a fight, I don't wanna trouble. So finally it's all done. We are done with varnish, with adding the wood. I have put some stones because I don't have the elk lamps to hold the wood in place, so I have put some stone. So now I will just have to let it dry and you will see the final product now.
So what's a makeover without the DIY? So I wanted to have a good candle stand on my TV unit. So I took this old branch of a tree which I had kept with me, sun dried it for a long time. So I just took it, I cut the edges so that it's not sharp and my baby doesn't get hurt because of this. And I took two nails and used a plank which was left of that pine wood board, attached it as the base and then gave it a just quick coat of varnish, and it was shining like a centerpiece, and yes, it looked stunning. So for the candles to stand, I drilled the circular holes as well so that the candles could stand properly in the openings there. Something about the way you make me feel. I don't wanna mess up your night, I don't wanna put up a fight, I don't wanna trouble you, babe, but I got to say, I don't wanna waste no more time trying to shake the feelings inside. Finally got made up my mind, can't go one more day without you. Finally all done. Ready for the final touches?
Once upon a time, there was a player in every corner doing tricks for a dime. All the streets were cold, he had his eyes on all the bright shining silver and gold. Oh, 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 as time went by so slowly, if only he could show me silver and gold. So pleasing, bright. silver and gold.
Pray for the final reveal. 1, 2, 3.
Please like our video
and please subscribe to our channel
Tranquil Living JS,
and I'll put one Instagram tag here.
Please follow us.
Please follow us and bye bye.
Please like our video
and
watch another video. Please like.
Look here and sing.
Welcome to our channel,
Tranquil Living JS. This is Jyoti.
And this is Sarav.
We hope you all are safe and sound.
Yes.
Yeah, that's me.